a dress rehearsal for the next commercial crew flight test, making room for another visitor at the space station, and a mission to test a next-generation solar sail. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. NASA astronauts Butch Wilmore and Sonny Williams, along with teams from NASA, Boeing, and United Launch Alliance, recently completed a dress rehearsal for our upcoming Boeing crew flight test to the International Space Station. Wilmore and Williams will be the first astronauts to fly to the space station aboard Boeing's Starliner spacecraft. Liftoff from Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida is targeted for May 6th. Meanwhile, to make room at the space station for the arrival of the Boeing Starliner spacecraft, the members of our SpaceX Crew 8 mission worked with ground controllers to relocate their SpaceX Dragon spacecraft to a different docking port. The move left the forward-facing port of the station's Harmony module open to accommodate the docking of the Starliner. The Advanced Composite Solar Sail System, or ACS-3, is a NASA mission that will test the use of a solar sail and the power of sunlight to propel a spacecraft. The tiny spacecraft was recently launched from New Zealand and is currently orbiting about 600 miles above Earth. It will undergo a 1 to 2 month commissioning phase. Then the mission team will set a date to unfurl ACS-3 solar sail. This mission could help advance future space travel and expand our understanding of our sun and solar system. The sun is entering a period of peak activity called solar maximum, which only occurs about every 11 years. It presents an unprecedented opportunity for two of our Mars spacecraft, Maven and Curiosity, to study how solar flares could affect robots and future astronauts on the red planet. Maven observes radiation, solar particles, and more from orbit high above Mars, while Curiosity's radiation assessment detector can help researchers understand how radiation impacts carbon-based molecules on the Martian surface. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more about what else we're up to, check out nasa.gov.